very good morning to you, family of God. We are so blessed to be coming to you on this Sunday morning from our home to yours. We thank God for this 31 days. We are on day 31 of the lockdown, and we thank God for his faithfulness. We thank God for all that he has done for us, and we just want to praise him and glorify him today. We thank God for the word that has encouraged us so much for the past 31 days. And we just thank God for who he is to us, for truly he's a great and a mighty God, and he has been faithful to us. I want to bless you with an encouragement today from the book of Isaiah, chapter 61. And this is a famous scripture that we read, but I want us to be an encouragement to others today. And the word of the Lord says in Isaiah 61, "The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because the Lord has anointed me to preach good tidings to the poor. He has sent me to heal the brokenhearted, to proclaim liberty to the captives, and the opening of the prison to those who are bound, to proclaim the acceptable year of the Lord, the day of vengeance of our God, to comfort all who mourn, to console those who mourn in Zion, to give them beauty for ashes, the oil of joy for mourning, the garment of praise for the spirit of heaviness, that they may be called trees of righteousness, the planting of the Lord, that he may be glorified." I pray this morning that the Spirit of the Lord is upon you, that God's anointing power will come upon you and your family, but not just for you, because the word of the Lord says that the anointing and the Spirit of the Lord, when it comes upon you, that you will be an encouragement to others. You know, many of us are in our homes, and during this time, we have reached out to people, we have reached out to some family members, some friends of ours. But today, I want you to trust God to lay someone on your heart, someone you haven't reached out to in a while. Because I believe that God is calling us at this time. When his Spirit comes upon us and his anointing rests upon us, he's calling us to encourage somebody today. He's calling us to encourage someone that may be feeling sorrowful today, someone that may be in mourning, somebody that may be feeling like they need some kind of joy in their life, someone that maybe needs to be encouraged with a word of praise, encouraged with a scripture that will bring joy to their hearts, someone that just needs to know that there is someone out there who loves them, who cares for them, who is thinking about them. So I want you to do this today. Take some time out of your day and phone someone, not just a WhatsApp message, but phone them, let them hear your voice and let them know that you love them and you care for them, and there's a God that loves them and a God that cares for them. So I want us to pray this morning, and we're going to pray before we get into a time of worship, and we're going to pray for people that need a touch from God. If you are sitting in your home today, maybe sitting on your bed or in your lounge with your family, and you need a touch from God, bow your heads with me this morning, and I want to pray for you. Father, we come before you in the mighty name of Jesus, the name that is above every other name. We thank you, Lord, that we can call upon your name, and no matter where we are in the world, that you're a God that hears, you're a God that answers, you're a God that loves us, and you're a God that cares. And so this morning, God, I bring your people before you, God. I pray, Lord Jesus, that you would touch and anoint them, my God. I pray that your Holy Spirit will come upon them today, God. Even in their homes, God, as they sit and would listen to this message, let the anointing of the Holy Spirit come upon us, God. That you will fill our hearts, you will fill our lives, you will fill our homes, Lord, with the Spirit of God today. I pray, Father, that you would touch and anoint every person that is watching and listening to this message today and to our service today. I pray, God, for those that are feeling discouraged, for those that are feeling down in their spirits this morning, I pray, God, that you would reach out and touch them, God. I pray that you would uplift them. I pray that you would anoint them, God. I pray, Father, that you would bring joy and peace and love into their homes, God. I pray, Father, that you would bring peace that no man can understand, God. I pray, Father, that you would be everything to them this morning, God. You touch and anoint your people, my God. You minister healing to them. You minister joy. You minister love. You minister peace. Because, Lord, in times like this, it is you, Lord, that we can count on. It is you that we can lean on. It is you, Lord, that we can rely on and have our hope and our faith and our trust in you. So we thank you, Lord. Help our people today to be encouragers. Help them, Lord, to be builders of others, God. And so we praise you and we bless you and we ask all these mercies in the wonderful name of Jesus. I pray that you would join us this morning. Join us as we sing and we praise unto God. You may be in your home, but sing a song unto the Lord and bless him and worship him today. So I'm going to hand you over to Joash now, and he's going to lead us in a time of worship. Let's just praise and magnify our God.
Mountains are still being moved. Strongholds are still being loosed. God, we believe. Yes, we can see the
name of God. Father, we declare, oh God, may your presence and may your powers, may your anointing, oh God, come over that place in the name of Jesus. Father, I thank you that you are transforming lives. You are changing lives around, oh God, in the name of Jesus. You are an awesome God. That we declare that healing is coming into the room. Healing of emotions, healing, oh God, of minds, healing, oh God, of physical bodies. In the name of Jesus, that we declare that there will be healing, oh God, from past hurts and pain, oh God. That we declare that the spirit of rejection, oh God, is removed. We declare, oh God, the spirit of low self-esteem, oh God, has been broken in the name of Jesus. Oh God, move upon your people in the name of Jesus. Make them everywhere whole in the name of Jesus. We speak healing, oh God, to their physical bodies. We speak healing, oh God, over their chest and over their lungs. Oh God, we pray today in the name of Jesus that every sickness, everything that has a name will bow to the name of Jesus. So we come, oh God, against high blood pressure and sugar diabetes. In the name of Jesus, Father, heart conditions, in the name of Jesus, Father, we come, oh God, that everything that causes stress and anxiety in the lives of your people, in the name of Jesus, Shakala Baba Baba Satala Lamahande, Rebeke Satele Behende, God is healing you from those back pains, in the name of Jesus, we speak strength to your knees right now, to whoever is pain in their knees, in the name of Jesus. God is causing that pain to go touch. Whichever part of your body is not well this morning, won't you just place your hand on it and just say, Lord, I'm trusting you. I'm trusting you. I'm trusting you just for healing. I'm trusting you for breakthrough in the name of Jesus. Those headaches are being removed right now in the name of Jesus. Weakness is leaving your body. The strength of God is coming in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, strength is coming in Jesus' name. We bless you. We bless you, Lord. We bless you, Lord.
Walking around this world, thank you.
desire just to worship. Our desire just to praise you. In Jesus' name. Amen. 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 There's one more song that I wanted you to do. Would you be able to do that? Bless the Lord. Come on, this is an older song, and I'd like you to sing with us. This is a song that you can just worship together with us. It speaks about the faithfulness of God, and something in my spirit tells me this morning that we need to just begin to say, Lord, this come in. There is much that you have done for us. There's much you're doing right now in this time, and we're asking God just begin to show up in our lives. Won't you join with us? Some thoughts from the book of Haggai, but the Lord just kept on pushing me towards the book of Matthew chapter 18. And this morning I want to just speak a simple word, but today I have a burden for those that are lost. I couldn't shake it, no matter what I would look at. I just feel a compulsion in my heart this morning to pray for those that do not know Jesus, for those that once knew Jesus but have turned away, for those that are in church but they're struggling with their faith, they're struggling with their commitment, they're struggling to really give their all to God. I'm saying to you today, Now is the acceptable time. I've entitled this message today that none will be lost. It is our desire that none will be lost. I'm reminded in the book of Samuel when we read of the account of Samuel, and then he is in the house of Eli. How even in the house of Eli, the priest over Israel, the one that was serving God, the one that was responsible for the people and the salvation of the people, yet in his house, his sons did evil in the sight of God. And the amazing thing was that he saw it and he did nothing about it. I pray that we will not remain silent in this time. I pray for every leader. I pray for everyone that has got children and the children have walked away from the Lord, adult children. And I know it's no responsibility of the parents because these are adults. But today, may you be the voice of the Lord. May you cry out before God. Like Abraham cries out before God when he hears that God was going to destroy Sodom. He began to pray. And he said, God, if there's 50. Then he goes and says, if there's 45. He says, if there's 40. He says, then he comes and says, God, if there's 20 or even 10, would you spare the country? You see, there was something about Abraham. He was not in the situation, but he had a loved one in that situation. Some of us got loved ones that are in church, but they do not really know God. I want to speak to you today. How long would you halt between two opinions? If God is God, serve him. Like Elijah on the Mount Carmel, he challenges the nation of Israel and he says, if God is God, serve him. If Baal is God, serve him. But do not halt between two opinions. God in the book of Revelation speaks to the church of Laodicea. And he says, I'd rather you be hot or cold, but not lukewarm. Because if you're lukewarm, I will spew you out of my mouth. Today, I want you to know, over the past few weeks, we found our lives being stripped away from everything that we thought was important. Places like hanging out at the mall, things that we would rush to, plans that we would make, things that going anywhere, going out, hanging out with friends and family were things some of us prioritized over God. But somehow God has arrested all of us and making us take stock of our lives. Let us not come out of this without having heard the word of the Lord. Often when God throughout scripture made drastic movements where he tried to get the attention of Israel, there was a particular reason he does it. He did it when the church and when Israel as a nation moved away from him and he wanted to call them to himself. And the Bible says the first thing Israel would do is they will fast and they would pray. But beyond fasting and prayer comes repentance. I want you to understand today, many of us live in a culture where we never ever repent, where there is no changing of our mind and a changing of our lifestyle and a changing of our conversation. We just almost automatically feel that God understands. The Bible says without repentance, repentance is important to God. Today, so many times, and I'm not talking only about you. The Bible says, for we have all sinned and come short of the glory of God. For anyone that has found themselves in a place where they're distant from God, today is the day. Today is the day for your healing. Today is the day for your deliverance. Today is the day for your returning. Some of you are sitting in the room and you're thinking of your children. You're thinking of loved ones. I have loved ones as well that I'm trusting God for salvation over their lives. As we take stock of our lives, let us come back to the place where we say, Lord, I surrender all to you, my blessed Savior, I surrender. There is no greater joy in the kingdom of God than seeing lost loved ones come back to God. So I want you today, as I keep on sharing the word of the Lord, remember your loved ones. Remember your sons. Remember your daughters. The Bible says if one in the household is saved, the entire household will be saved. You may be the one in the household that is listening and saying, God, I'm praying for my family. I believe the whole household will be saved. Some of you are saying, God, it seems so difficult. I've spoken so many times to them. But today, hand them over to the Lord. Allow His Spirit to work in their lives. Because we can change nobody. None of us can change anybody by any effort of our own. But as we hand them over to the Lord, we say, Lord, encounter them. The other day we had a person on our Facebook leave a message, there's no Jesus. If you're listening to us today, I want you to know that Jesus is alive. That Jesus is alive and He can heal and He can touch you and change your life if you would give Him an opportunity. Yes, situations seem hopeless. Yes, choices have led us down this road where we don't even want to believe anymore. But hear this from me. Jesus is alive. I'm evidence of it. I'm evidence of one that could not speak. But when Jesus touched my life, He restored my speech. I stand here today not telling you about a Jesus I did not encounter. I've encountered Him many times. I'm talking about someone that I've been in numerous car accidents where cars were written off and I came out of it without a scratch, not because of anything I have done, but because of Jesus Christ. I'm here to tell you today that Jesus can watch over you. I found myself in situations where I could have been dead, but Jesus showed up. I'm here to tell you today, God is in your life. God will watch over you. This is not an arrogant statement. Only you need Him, He needs you to begin to trust Him in your life, in your family. Yes, career may be going well, and you may be enjoying success in every sphere of your life, but there seems to be an area in your personal life where you feel empty. I'm saying you try Jesus. The Bible said that as Annie encouraged us today, He gives us beautiful ashes. The oil of joy for mourning, the garments of praise for the spirit of heaviness. That the Bible says that heaven rejoices over one sinner that gives their heart to the Lord. All you have to do is say, Lord Jesus, come into my life. Touch me. Matthew chapter 18 verse 10. Jesus is speaking a parable, and we know that a parable is an earthly story with a heavenly meaning. And He says, see that you do not despise one of these little ones. For I tell you that the angels in heaven always see the face of my Father in heaven. What do you think? If a man owns 100 sheep, and one sheep wanders away, will he not leave the 99 on the hills and go and look for the one that wandered off? And if he finds it, truly I tell you, he is happier about the one than about the 99 that did not wander off. In the same way, your heavenly Father is not willing that any should be lost or perish. In the number of years that I've been ministering, there are so many young men and women, brothers and sisters, that say they are members of the church. And you would see them on the Easter, the Mother's Day, Father's Day, the Christmas service or a celebration service. That's not salvation. Some we would see once a month. That's not salvation. Some would say, I've got no excuse, Pastor, I was just lazy. But that's an excuse also. How can we neglect such greater salvation? How can we neglect such greater salvation? I've had so many requests and so many people that are saying, Pastor, I miss church. But the time when the church is available and open, they're not there. And this is not a judgment, my brother, my sister. This is out of a compassion that I want to know that you have given your heart to the Lord. I want to know that your name is written in the Lamb's Book of Life. I want to know that if you close your eyes on this side of eternity, on the other side you will be in heaven. You will be with our Heavenly Father. I want to know for a confidence in my heart that I will see you again. I want to know. And I feel we will be failing if I do not tell you that heaven is real. Hell is real. I'll be failing if I do not tell you that it is God's desire that none will be lost. We've seen there's no more parties, there's no more friends, there's no more hanging out. Every excuse has been removed. We've got brothers and sisters that have been struggling with addictions, with alcoholism, with drugs. There's been more than 21 days. They say it takes 21 days to break a habit. Today, won't you just trust God? Use this time to say, God, I'm asking you to come into my life. Can I lead you to the Lord today? Can we pray together? If you've got a loved one, call their name before the Lord. Son, daughter, don't think you're young. You've got your whole life ahead of you. I can tell you there's no better life than a life in Jesus. For you that have been backslidden, don't be ashamed. Like the prodigal son, the Bible says when he came to himself, he says, even in my Father's house, the servants have much more. All the world will do is use you for what you have. And once they have used you for all that they have, they would spit you out. I want you to know, God doesn't want you for what you have. He loves you for you. The Bible says, while we were yet sinners, Christ Jesus died for us. I pray today, heaven rejoices over one soul that is saved. All I'm doing is trusting God for one soul. If it be many, praise God. Even if I don't know your name, heaven will record what is taking place today. Would you bow your heads together with me? Would you pray this prayer with me, everyone that is listening? Lord Jesus, I come before you today. I ask you to come into my life. Lord, I accept you as my Lord and Savior. I believe that you sent your son Jesus to come and die so that I can be restored and salvation can be mine. Lord, I confess my sins. I've made some mistakes. I've sinned against you. I've walked away from you. But today, Lord, I ask you to come into my life. Today, Lord, I ask you to come and change me. Today, I declare that I am a child of God. I can assure you there's a rejoicing in heaven. There's a rejoicing in heaven, my brother. Alcohol has had control over you, but no longer. Some of you, your kidneys have been affected, and your livers have been affected by drugs and alcohol, but today I'm praying that God is healing you from inside. Some of you have got chest infections and chest and lung conditions as a result of long-term smoking. I'm praying that God is going to begin to reverse it. I'm praying today for the person that has been battling with a tight chest and shortness of breath. Right now, in the name of Jesus, let healing come over your body in the name of Jesus, that your airways will begin to open up. Your airways will begin to open up in the name of Jesus. Shakala mando robo sete lebehende rakasata. Riba shalabodo robo sita. In Jesus' name, let healing come. You're a God of miracles. You are Jehovah Rapha. And there is nothing too difficult for you. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for salvation. Thank you for healing. This morning, if you have your emblems with you, you want to partake of the table of the Lord together. And we're praying today that as we pray for salvation, that God will bless. Father, over these emblems, in the name of Jesus, we bless it. We bless it in the name of Jesus. Kashalamanda Rabasata. And so, Lord, even as we partake of this, we do remember our Lord Jesus Christ. The victory we have through Christ Jesus. Father, bless your people. May you break through on their behalf, that we believe that it is sealed in heaven. Whatever you said is bound in on the earth will be bound in heaven. Whatsoever is loosed on the earth will be loosed in heaven. And so today we declare freedom and breakthrough over the lives of your people in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. You may partake of the emblems. Amen. Good day. God bless you. Keep trusting the Lord. I pray that God will increase your faith in Him. And do something. Reach out to someone. Encourage someone. Bless someone today in Jesus' name. See you tomorrow morning at 9 o'clock. Amen.